Well, we kick off the show with American spoken word artist Preston Perry, who talks about how he quit rap for poetry and how in his heart, rap was corrupted and poetry was innocent. Well, enjoy this one.
Have you ever dreamt a dream that felt so real that it's like time stood still just so you could visit a moment that was sure to come in your future? Because I have. And in that moment, I stood face to face in a place so beautiful.
Chicago-based rapper and spoken word artist Preston Perry discovered his talent in junior secondary school, rising to become the best in his grade.
A more radiant land man has ever known, the trees, was a cesspool of vibrant colors.
It was a thing called battle rap, where we would stand in front of another guy, and you basically would talk about his mama, you would talk about his clothes, and you would see who could come up with the best metaphors. Ninth grade, I became really good at it. Became like the freestyle champion in my high school, and it kind of just went from there.
Searching for wisdom in a mere branch, we forgot about the God who had the power to grow us from dust with no roots. His mind is wide as sky, and we were free as clouds, but now the silent hum of shame echoes the land. The eerie chill of Father's curse crawls across our conscience, and the very river we bathe our naked souls in is damned because of you. What have you done?
Do not blame me for murder and name yourself victim as if we are not both ghosts with skin.
You left me for dead. Did you forget the sixth day when God made you from dust?
But he made you from me for me.
While sleeping, he called you from my cage, bones beautiful, but you, with your prideful disposition, switched positions and tried to lead. Took heed to a four-legged snake without consulting me first. You didn't respect me.
He gave you authority. He made you the head of us, but you became neck. I can still see the apple stuck in your throat, Adam. Swallow your pride.
With so much potential and a chance to pursue a career in rap, a music genre revered by millions in America and all over the world, Perry quits. He experienced a spiritual renewal, which alienated him from rap music.
Please understand that you further prove my point. That prideful organ brewing beneath your breast beats with no submission for your husband. And for this, your future daughters would not be quiet, gentle.
But he took up poetry instead.
This was us before our true feelings shot from our hearts, flew out of our mouths, and landed in each other's lives like two beautifully made missiles we didn't quite know what to do with. Admiring the way they were well constructed, but fearing that they might explode at any time to blow off the limbs of our emotions, and I knew this.
Actually, I started writing poetry before I started writing rap. But I was an active rapper before I was an active poet, if that makes sense. I started writing poetry when I was in 12th grade. I kept getting into fights in school. My mentor, she came to me and said, I really need you to create an outlet to express yourself. And she asked me, what do I like to do? I said, I like to write down my thoughts. So I wrote this poem, and she cried. And that was the first time I ever made anybody cry or have emotion. And then she just kind of like instilled in me this truth that my words have power. And then I was a creative person. So I started writing poetry ever since then. It wasn't until I met the Lord, but I really felt the Lord leading me to do spoken word poetry, to leave rap behind, because rap was just such an idol in my heart. It was such an art form where I put so much pride and boasted in myself.
3 years ago, you stood on this stage and declared how the Lord broke the shackles of homosexuality off of your predestined life, with boldness roaring out of your mouth as if a lion lived in your throat. And I saw the truth that day. I saw a young woman longing for righteousness like lungs long for air. And I guess that explains why it was so hard for me to breathe when you spit. Your testimony held the crowd together like the sea holds the sunrise. And at the end of your poem, when you told every woman in the room that they were beautiful, I believed you, because the sincerity soaring from your chest sounding like the cry of a caged bird longing for sky. You spoke like a gentle storm. Calm enough to ease our anxious souls, but violent enough to lift us off of our feet when you finished. And when you finished, I said to myself, yo, who is this girl? And how did she just melt my face off? I never told you, but you are the virtue my eyes have unknowingly been longing to gaze upon. A real life Proverbs 31 woman in the flesh.
He
If rap was corrupted for him, poetry represented a part of him he kept away from the world. But he believes following that path was divinely orchestrated.
Poetry was always an art form that I had that nobody knew I wrote except a couple girlfriends and my mom. I didn't let my homies know that I wrote poetry because I didn't want nobody to think I was soft. But when I became a Christian, the Lord showed me that it was an art form that I haven't defiled in my heart, you know, and it was still innocent and pure. And I think that's the reason why the Lord chose me to do that art form. So I've been doing it ever since.
I believe that there's a beautiful covenant waiting for us on the other side of this relationship. A new covenant filled with love, pain, and joy, and sacrifice that all brings glory to the King who rose us from the dead. So with that said, I'm coming down there.
For Perry, poetry has become more powerful than rap. He now uses his talent on the P4CM platform to address social issues, including violence and relationships.
Well, I started doing poetry in 2008. It was a group in Chicago called Spoken Life Project. And we started an event in Chicago called Speak Life Chicago. And it grew out to something really, really big. And I wrote this poem called Chicago's Hope about just the violence in my city. And it started to just impact a lot of people in Chicago. But it wasn't until I came to P4CM, was at 2010, I believe, and I wrote this collaboration piece called Soul Ties with this girl named Itohan. And that poem kind of just went viral. And that was the first time I kind of seen like a global impact that it had. People writing me, telling me they got set free from sin or sexual sin from my poem. But yeah, I think that's what art does. I think that's the reason why most of the Old Testament is poetry.
She is a reflection of her family, so with fear of making them look damaged, she pretends like she has it all together on the outside, but on the inside, she is a Holocaust. Too rubble and war to be whole, too broken of a nation to be complete. And all her life, Christ has been their righteous government. She has been afraid to seek, but fear for family secrets being exposed. All she wishes is to be free. But she is a desperate desert at dawn, radiant to look at, but not enough thirst in her soul for Jesus to flourish. She is in bondage, a 24-year-old girl who leads the church choir with a voice like a saint. But she is a sinner.
I think poetry is just different and unique in its own vein, because I think poetry stands alone. I would never forget the first time I got on stage when people actually knew me and knew of my art, and I can look in the crowd and look and make eye contact, kind of like what I'm doing with you. And everybody was just anticipating what I was gonna say. I had no beat, I had no music, I had no instruments behind me. It was just my words.
A son more faithful than the morning, and a son so powerful that it only had to rise once.